Good afternoon, students. So today we see equations reducible to clarets form. In the last class, we have solved the problems on clarets form. So where the problems are readily in clarets form. Okay, so then we find the general solution and particular solution, and then we write the solution, total solution. Now in this, the given problems are not in clarets form. Okay. Today, so we see the problems, so where they are not in clarets form, so we have to reduce those problems in clarets form by making suitable substitution. Now see, for example, find the general and singular solution of x square into y minus px equal to y p square by using the substitution x square equal to u and y square equal to v. So now these are the substitutions we have to use. So by using these substitutions, we reduce the given equations in clarets form. So let us see how to do this. The given equation is x square into y minus px equal to y p square. Now here again, put x square equal to u and y square equal to v here. Then differentiate. This gives 2x dx equal to du. Differentiate this also. 2y dy equal to dv. Now divide these two. So which gives 2y dy divided by 2x dx, 2 to get cancelled. So y dy by x dx equal to, and RHS, RHS is divided by, so this is dv by du. So now from this, we calculate y by x. This is y by x. Now dy by dx means it is p, which is equal to, now dv by du. So let us take this one as capital P. Okay, so therefore here we written a small p is nothing but dy by dx, and capital P is dv by du. So use this as capital P and use this as small p. Now from this, calculate p value. So p is equal to, this is cross multiplied x by y into capital P. Therefore the given equation becomes, after getting the value of p, now we substitute this value of p in the given here, in the given equation, that is in this. Here we substitute the value of p. Okay, so let us see what we'll get. So that is u into y minus x square by y p is equal to y into x square by y square into p square. Just substitute this p is equal to x by y into capital P in the given problem and simplify. Simplify, so then we get this equation. Now again taking LCM for this, then we will get some y and y term will get cancelled. So we will get this equation. Again, this is u. Now y square is nothing but v. Y square is nothing but v. And x square is u, capital P. Then this y and y get cancelled. Okay, so x square means u. This is p square. Or v minus up is equal to, this u get cancelled, is equal to p square. Or v is equal to, bring this term here, up plus p square. So now this is a claret form. Now this is a claret's form. So therefore the general solution is, the general solution is obtained by replacing this capital P by c. So which gives v is equal to uc plus c square. Now resubstitute the value of u and v. So v means y square, u means x square plus c square. Now to find the singular solution, differentiate one. So differentiate one with respect to capital P. So when we differentiate this with respect to capital P, which gives this is u plus 2p equal to, this is du, because v is not a function of p. So therefore dv by dp is 0. Is 0. From this you calculate p, p value is minus u by 2. Now substitute this value of p in the given equation, okay, in equation 1, that is here, okay, here. Then we will get v is equal to minus u square by 2 plus u square by 4, which implies v is minus u square by 2. Or cross multiplying and all that, we will get 2v plus u square equal to 0. Now resubstitute the value of u and v. So v means y square, 2y square, plus u means it is x square. So u square means x raised to 4. So plus x raised to 4 equal to 0. So this is a singular solution. Similarly, we solve the second one, that is to find the general and singular solution of this p minus 1 into e raised to 3x plus p cube e raised to 2y equal to 0. By using the substitution, u is equal to e raised to x and v is equal to e raised to y. Now the given equation is, this is a given equation, write this given equation. Next, make the substitution, u is equal to e raised to x and v is equal to e raised to y. Differentiate this, du is equal to e raised to x dx. Differentiate this, dv is equal to e raised to y dy. Now divide these two, dv by du is equal to e raised to y by e raised to x. This is dy by dx. Now from this we calculate dy by dx, it's equal to e raised to x by e raised to y dv by du. Now this is dy by dx is nothing but small p. This is e raised to x divided by e raised to y. Now dv by du is capital P, as we done in the last problem. So which is equal to e raised to x means u, this is u, so u, e raised to y means it is v, so you write here v, capital P. Now from this where p is equal to dy by dx and capital P is dv by du. Therefore the given equation becomes, now substitute this value of p in the given equations, we get this equation, and simplify this equation. And then lastly we get pv is equal to up plus pq. Again this is a Clairaut's form. Clairaut's form. Now it is reduced to Clairaut's form. So therefore general solution is obtained by replacing capital P by C. So general solution is v is equal to uc plus cq. So now resubstitute the value of v. V means e raised to x, which is equal to u means e raised to y. E raised to y c plus cq. Now to find the singular solution, what we do? We differentiate this equation with respect to capital P, which gives 2u plus 3p square equal to 0. Now from this you calculate p square value. P square is minus u by 3, which implies p is a square root of minus u by 3. Now putting this value of p in the given equation 1, so that is in this equation. Then we get this one, or v is equal to simplifying, which gives square root of minus u by 3 into u minus u by 3, or which implies v is equal to square root of minus u by 3 into 2u by 3. Now squaring on both the sides, which get u square is v square is equal to minus u by 3 into 4u square by 9, or v square is equal to minus 4 u cube divided by 27, or which implies 4u square plus 27 v square equal to 0. Or 4, resubstitute the value of u and v, so 4 e raised to 3x plus 27 e raised to 2x equal to 0. Okay, so this is how we solve equations which are not in readily in Clairaut's form. So we have to reduce those problems in Clairaut's form by making the some substitutions. Okay, so this is all for today's session, and I'll continue in the next class. Thank you.